Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Y'all come on in here. Good morning. Grace and peace. Grace and peace, Mrs. Short. Praying that you had an amazing first Christmas as Mrs. Short. Amen. Good morning, everybody. Hallelujah. It's so good to see you. Hoping that Christmas was fantastic for everybody. That's my sincere hope. Listen, we are in the absolute. Good morning, Tasha. Good morning, Evangelist Tasha. Coach TJ in the house. Good morning, Shirley Ree. Y'all roll on in here. Thank you so much for overlooking my tardiness this morning. Had a brief distraction, but that's life. Amen. I tell you what, I'm excited about where we are today. We are officially in the last week of 2021, right? My God, my God, my God. I'm excited about 2022 coming. Good morning, Evangelist and Scott. Good morning. Y'all come on in here. I'm super excited about the place that we're in right now in the world. We're rounding the bend to of 2021 and headed like a locomotive into 2022. But what I want to say this morning is hold up. Hold up. I want to say slow your roll just a little bit. Even though we're headed towards 2022, we do not want to leave anything on the table undone, uncompleted, unfocused, half in, half out in 2021. Whatever is within our power and ability and our charge from heaven to take care of, we want to make sure that we do our very best to wrap things up as neatly as possible. So, on that note, my message for you this morning is refocus your focus and finish it. Mm-hmm. Refocus. Somebody throw that up in the chat for me. And go ahead, if you don't mind, and share the broadcast with somebody that you think could benefit from it. You know, because we all need to reset. We've been in this holiday season since October, basically. We've been in a whirlwind of activities, preparations, all of that for Thanksgiving and then for Christmas. And now we're already planning for what's going to take place on New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. We're trying to figure out how we're going to spend our time, how we're going to set it off, my God, for 2022. But what I want to say this morning is still hold up, wait a minute, glory to God. I want to say that again, hold up and wait a minute, my God. Don't be so quick to fly, to soar. Oh, God, to speed out of here with your foot all the way with the pedal to the metal into 22, that you forget that God is still working miracles in 2021. God is still able to do some things for you. Hallelujah, in 2021. The stones, the tides are still able to turn in your favor, baby, in 2021. My God, we've got to refocus our focus. What have we been focusing on? We've been focusing on the Christmas list, the Christmas shopping, the Thanksgiving cooking, the Thanksgiving preparation, the Christmas cooking, shopping, preparation. And what did we tell ourselves? Through all of that, we said, I got to finish my list. I got one more gift to get. Oh, no, no, no. I actually got three more gifts to get. I need to get some more Christmas tree ornaments. I need to get another ham to go with that turkey. I need to get some more potatoes. I need to do this. I need to do that. And we have strategically been reminding ourselves over and over again. Oh, I need two more rolls of wrapping paper. That's right. I wanted to change that wreath on the front door this year. We've been strategically reminding ourselves, oh, I got to send out the invitation. I want to make sure that Aunt Betty knows that I want her to come over and be with us on Christmas Day. We've been strategically reminding ourselves of what we need to do holiday preparation wise. Well, I came to let somebody know today that now, hallelujah, it's time to press the restart button. It's time to press the restart button and refocus our focus so that we can finish. My God. God, you know, wants us to finish, guys. He wants us to finish. I know that personally, I've got a couple of things that I've kind of let slide to the back burner for a minute now while I focus on this immediate Christmas stuff, focus on this immediate Thanksgiving stuff, focus on this immediate work stuff. But what about the God stuff? What about the stuff that we are needing to be continually working on to build and create a legacy that's going to supersede Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's Eve and New Year's Day? What about those steps that we started at some point in 2021, but for whatever reason, we've gotten away from them? You know, we might have got tired during the journey. We might have ran into a roadblock and had to pause to reevaluate, re-energize, to revamp our MOA. You know, we might have had to pull back just a little bit to figure out the proper way to continue to move forward. And in the midst of all of that, we have come into this holiday whirlwind. My God, wrapping up end of year work projections and work evaluations and all of these kind of things. But I want to encourage somebody this morning, pick it back up again. You've still got some time left on the clock. God is still able. He's still in control. He's still majorly in charge. My God. And while he is able to do some things, the bigger part of my assignment this morning is to remind you that you are able to do some things. Get the laptop back out again. Get the pen back out. Get the pencil back out. Pull the materials back out of the closet from underneath the couch where you tucked them away in storage. Oh God, it is time, my Lord, to get back to work, refocus and finish it. And you know, when I say finish it, what I mean is wrap it up. We're at the end of year, the time of year where we're wrapping things up. You know, we've been wrapping up the gifts. I took my time. I was strategic with every gift that I wrapped up. I cut the wrapping paper just so. I measured out how much I wanted on each end, on each side. I figured out where I wanted to put the tape, what kind of tape. I don't want that yucky cheap tape. I want the clear, transparent tape that's going to disappear so the package looks pretty and neat and beautiful. I was so strategic, you guys. I was so strategic that I wanted to use X amount of this fashion paper, wrapping paper, and then I want to switch up and I want to use this color and this style and this decor of paper over there. We've got to use the same strategies and tactics, the same specific and careful care with finishing the great works that God has put in us and charged us with at the top of 2021. See, we're at the bottom of 2021 now. But if you look back, do all the boxes check off? Did we finish it? How far did we get with it? Where did we stop? What made us stop? We were running well. We were doing well. We were monitoring our breathing as we were going. We were checking in. We had accountability partners, all of that. What happened? We're at December 28th, 2021. Now our heart is beating a little fast, thinking about things that have not been wrapped up as tight as they should have. Oh God, I said I was going to be finished this by the end of the year. Oh my goodness. I wrote down in my journal. I wrote down in my log. Oh God, I put the calendar date in my phone on my calendar by December 28th. It's going to be wrapped up. It's going to be done. It's going to be finished. My God, thank you so much. You guys go ahead and share the broadcast. This is good. People need to be encouraged. Oh God, to get a second wind, a third, a fourth, a fifth wind if necessary, whatever it takes in order to refocus their focus and finish it. finish that thing that you set in your heart at the top of the year to do. My God, listen, another way we can look at finishing it, wrapping it up, we can look at it as anchoring down or anchoring up. We've been on Dive In all year long, and we've been putting anchors up and putting anchors down, howsoever we need to do. I want you to think today about what kind of anchor you need. Do you need to drop? What do you need to do with your anchor? At this point, few days left, oh God, in this year, the hours in the natural realm are what they are. What do you need to do to get where you need to be? To build what you need to build, to complete, to finish, to wrap up what you need to complete, to build, to finish, to wrap up what you said that you wanted to do, what you wrote down that was ascribed to you. My God, according to what has been placed on the inside of you, where are you at this date and point in time in 2021? I want to say to you today, don't fear. Don't freak out. Don't stress out. Don't fall apart. It's not time for that. What you need to do is either pull your anchor up and get moving to the next port that you're supposed to be at, or you need to drop your anchor. You need to put your anchor down. You need to hunker down. You need to dig your heels in, put your hands back to that plow, and you need to get to moving, sister. You need to get to moving, brother. And listen, it just came to me. So many times we say, finish strong. I'm a realist. If you guys know or have gleaned anything about me, I am a realist, okay? It is what it is to some degree. But that's, you know, I can let and make my supernatural, oh God, overshadow my natural thought processes when it comes to that. You know, we got different levels and tiers. But listen, I want to say to you this. You can still get it done. You're more in it than what you think. You're closer than what you think. Oh God, and the super will rise up, come down rather, to meet your natural when you rise your natural up. Yesterday morning, I was walking. I walked about almost 6,300 steps yesterday morning. Just, you know, getting some fresh air, listening to the Lord and all of that. I had my headphones on, listened to something inspirational to keep my spirit up and help me keep moving. That's a nugget for somebody right there. Share the broadcast, you guys. You got to figure out a way to energize yourself, motivate yourself, inspire yourself. Nike says, just do it. I just saw that in my reflection here. Nike says, just do it. But that's easier said than done. And I want to put that on the table because it's a real thing. It's easier said than done. When we say finish strong, finish the year strong, finish strong. You got to finish strong. Come on now, rise up, finish strong. Listen, the Holy Spirit showed me athletes, you know, in all different types of settings. Take a runner, for example, because I'm a light runner myself and I've love to run. Listen, any runner that finish a race, okay, we might say they finish strong, but if you ask that runner will tell you that they feel broken down. That runner will tell you, my heart feels like it's about to bust wide open in my chest. That runner will tell you, I feel like I don't have another ounce of energy or strength. That runner will tell you, I didn't think I could hardly make it, but something on the inside of me said, keep right on putting one foot in front of the other. Stay focused, refocus. A runner will tell you that the way I finished the race was I commanded myself to refocus my focus. When I wanted to look around and see if the other runners were coming up fast on my heels, I refused to do so. I had to focus on me. I had to focus on what was set before me. I had to focus on my concepts about how far that finish line was ahead of me. What is it going to take to get there? I had to refocus my focus and stop thinking, I can't make it. I'm about to give out. I can't hardly get there. I don't know how I'm going to do it. The runner will tell you, I had to refocus my focus. I had to change my thought pattern. I had to change my belief system. As I was running, I had to change my thoughts. I had to command my thoughts to be higher. I had to command them to be higher than what I felt on the inside. They are telling me, finish strong, finish strong, finish strong, finish strong. I could even hear my coach in my ear gate. The runner will tell you, I could even hear my coach in my ear gate, in my imagination, through all those thousands of hours of training for this marathon, saying, finish strong, finish strong, finish strong, get there, get there, get there, get there. I could hear Nike, just do it, just do it, just do it, just do it. The runner will tell you, I heard those voices behind my ear gates and I kept going. But the truth of the matter is, as I was going, I still, truth be told, felt like I couldn't hardly make it. So finish strong has a new trajectory for me this morning. Finish strong doesn't mean that you've got to finish fast. Finish strong does not mean that you've got to finish furiously. Finish strong does not mean that you got to rack up a mountain level of numbers. Finish strong does not mean, my God, that you've got to wear yourself completely out getting it done. Finish strong to me on this morning means that you finish intentionally. You finish strategically. You finish with purpose. And even finish strong may not mean finish, quote unquote, in the literal sense, as incomplete, done, finite, it's over. I don't have to pick my hands up with it anymore. Finish strong may simply mean for somebody this morning that you finish 2021 out working on it, giving attention to it, giving focus to it, giving energy to it, giving time to it, giving consistency to it, being creative with it. I'm not leaving, my God, it sitting in the oven unattended to. I've got my eyes on it. That's one of the reasons why I'm playing Eye of the Tiger in the backdrop here today from the Rocky movie. You know all about that. Don't have time to go into all of that. But Rocky had to finish. You know, he had to finish. And if you saw the Rocky series, the Rocky movies, I don't know how many they had, but if you saw that, y'all share the broadcast for me, please. If you saw the Rocky series, every single time he won, every single time he was able to stand up there with his hands lifted up at the very end, he was about to give out. He didn't have nothing left. You know why? Because he left it all in the ring. He left it all in the ring, on the ring floor, on the ring ropes. And my job today is to encourage you to get back in the ring. If you step out of the ring during 2021 for whatever reason, if you stepped out of the ring, step back in the ring. It's not too late. You can still, my God, get a passing grade from Jesus Christ. You can still get a passing grade from Father God, our everlasting daddy. You can still get a passing grade from the Holy Spirit if you just get back in the ring. If you just pick it back up again. If you just reset. Hit the reset button. If you just refocus your focus and finish it, because finish it doesn't mean, literally mean, the same thing for everybody. Now, let me prove that to you. 2 Corinthians 8 and 11 in the NIV version says, now finish the work so that your eager willingness to do it may be matched by your completion of it, but check this out, according to your means. Everybody's means level is not the same. According to the measure of faith that you have been given. According to the resources that are at your disposal. According to the natural helps and the spiritual helps that you have to support you in your endeavors. According to your mindset to move yourself forward in spite of everything. Oh, I forgot what I was saying earlier. Yesterday when I was walking my route, doing my exercise, I had my earbud in, listening to some motivational, inspirational thing. And all of a sudden, over the inspiration that was coming into my ear gate, I heard a strange sound. I heard a noise that caused me to stop, to pause, to take the earbud out, because I'm all about my surroundings, okay? I'm all about that. But I realized what I heard was my feet were dragging. I was walking. I'm out power walking. My route, feeling pretty good. Sun is shining, low 70 degrees. But I realized all of a sudden, Coach TJ, that my feet were dragging. And the moment that I realized my feet were dragging, the Holy Spirit said to me, pick up your feet. I almost named this morning, pick up your feet. But I got something else coming next year that I'm going to use that in. But pick up your feet. I don't know who you are this morning, that for whatever reason, you've been dragging your feet. And we know that dragging your feet, quote unquote, is a colloquial saying that means you've been procrastinating. It means that you've been lazy about it. It means that you've been hesitant when you should be intentionally focused and moving forward. So I came this morning, oh God, to encourage you, pick up your feet. Let me say it like this, pick up the pace. For some people, that means to simply get in the car and get them moving because you had the car parked in the garage and you have put the key in the storage container and you haven't even tried to start the car up. It's been so long since you even cranked it up and tried to move it that you two don't even have a relationship. You and your car, quote unquote, your car is your gifts. Your car is your strengths. Your car, my God, is your ability. The car is your anointing. The car is the thing that you were called and designed and birthed and born out to do. It's in there. Refocus your focus and finish it. I want you to get the eye of the tiger spirit all over you. I want you to get the eye of the tiger spirit because the eye of the tiger spirit is a persevering spirit. Yes, it helps you to pick up your feet. That's how the runner gets to the end of the race. My God. Everybody on the outside looking in, oh, they're finishing strong. They're finishing strong. You know why they're saying they're finishing strong? It's not because they're finishing fast. It's not because they're finishing so powerfully looking. Rah, rah, rah. No, finishing strong means that they finished. It means that in spite of the broke downness of the natural man, the hamstring got torn, the ankle got twisted. Oh God, the spasms were happening in the back. The head was bursting and pounding with every footstep that picked up and picked down, but they kept moving forward towards it. That's finishing strong. 2 Corinthians 8 and 11 in the New Living Translation says, now, that's a powerful word, now, N-O-W, three letters, you still got time. I want somebody to throw up in the chat for me, now, the word now, speak to yourself, now, you can still do it, you can still win, you can still end strong. The word says, I'm using just this one verse, 2 Corinthians 8 and 11, NLT version says, now you should finish. It says you should finish. Now you should finish. Now you should finish. We can look at that. We can say it in a couple of ways. Now you should finish. Now you should finish. Put the emphasis wherever you want to put it. And it changes the trajectory of it depending on how you fluctuate it with your tone of voice. Whatever it takes for you to hear your own self speak these words, you say it that way, okay? Now you should finish. I've got some things, LaTanya, that I should finish. And I'm going to finish because I'm refocusing my focus today. Glory to God. You should finish what you started. Let the eagerness you show, check this out, in the beginning, be matched now by your giving. Giving, be matched now. Let me break this down a little bit. Let the eagerness you showed in the beginning, you started off well. Every runner starts off fully energized, fully invigorated, fully hyped up. But the longer you run, the more miles you go, the more hills you go up, oh God, the more curves you got to take, oh God, the more exertion is put on the body, the energy level kind of wanes away. It kind of goes down a little bit, but we got to still keep going. We have to still keep moving. But the word says here, let the eagerness, let the passion. I want to encourage you today, get your passion back. These last few days of 2021, somebody needs to refocus your passion level. You need to refocus and get your passion back. Get your excitement back about it. Get your expectation about the outcome of it back. Hey, get your excitement about the journey. We get so hyped up and so zonked out about the outcome. Oh, I'm going to get that license. I'm going to get that license. I'm going to pass that test. I'm going to do this. I'm going to get this. I'm going to get that. That we don't even enjoy the journey. We miss the jewels along the journey. Somebody put in the chat for me, don't miss the jewels along the journey. But we gotta get our passion back. We got to get our attention and focus back. The English Standard Version says, so now finish doing it as well, so that your readiness in desiring it may be matched by your completing it, check this out of what you have. You don't have to worry about what you don't have. Don't use excuses. Don't make it a bona fide reason, okay? I would have, but, I ought to, but, I thought about it, but, I tried to, but, the word says you should finish what you started. Unless God gives you some kind of indication that you need to scrap that. The season for that is over. The season for that is done. Now, those things you need maturity to properly discern when the season is over. The season has changed. The season is finite. It's complete. It ain't summer no more. It's not fall anymore. It's definitely not spring anymore. I'm in the winter time right now, so I'm going to act like it when I go out the front door, okay? You got to maturely and properly discern your seasons and times. Ecclesiastes 3, there's a time and a season for everything, baby. Time to gather stones, time to throw them away. We got to know where we are. And don't worry about where anybody else is but you. Do you. Run your race. Finish your charge. Finish it. Finish it. And I want you, as I get ready to click off of here, I want you to check in with yourself, really. I want you to check in with you. If you haven't finished what you said you would have finished by now, what's the reason for it? What hindered your run? Where did you stumble as you were carrying that gridiron, that pigskin, running to the touchdown line? What hindered you? Where did you trip up? Now, this requires some transparency with self. It requires a self-examination. One of my favorite lines from Shakespeare, to thine own self be true. If you haven't finished, what's the reason? Where did the holdup take place? Where did the hiccup happen? Where did you fall in the hole in the sidewalk again? What emotional thing overtook you and caused you to stumble and fall? Why did you screech, come to a screeching halt? You were going well, and but then all of a sudden, you just stopped, just like that. Choo. What was behind that? What was the reason for it? I need you to check in with yourself. Check in with yourself, because this is all about you. This is about you and about God. This is about your life. This is about what you want. This is about what you need. This is about what you ascribe to do, who you ascribe to be. This is about your destiny. This is about your destiny. This is about your destiny. And we've got to get an eye of the tiger mentality. We've got to get a just do it, a Nike just do it mentality. We've got, if you need to change your constitution, you need to change your constitution. Don't hold on to it just because you said you were going to hold on to it. Remember, if the season is up, baby, the season is up. If you need to do a trade-in, a divine exchange, so you can continue on, then you got to do that. Whatever you need to do. If you got on too many clothes, because runners only run with a very minimal amount of clothing because they don't want to be weighted down unnecessarily, because it will hinder the journey. It will hinder the race each and every time. A swimmer, very moderate amount of clothing. You got to dress properly for your battles, for your journey, for your excursions. You've got to spiritually and naturally dress properly so that you can refocus your focus and finish it. Your strong might not be like the other person's strong, and vice versa. And it's cool. That is copacetic. It's okay. It's okay. According to what you have in 2 Corinthians 8:11, according to the measure of faith that has been given to you, that you flow and operate out of, you owe it to yourself. You owe it to yourself, amazing person you. You owe it to yourself. You owe it to your children and your children's children. You owe it to those souls that are attached to your life. You owe it, my God, to your dreams and your visions and your aspirations. You owe it to you. You owe it to you to make your own self proud, not about trying to get accolades from anybody else, but you. And it's not about pride. It's not about ego. It is about soul satisfaction. It's about spiritual satisfaction. It's about, my God, being able to tell your own self, well done, you good and faithful servant. Well done. So guess what? Pick your feet up. Whoever you are, pick your feet up and get moving. Pick your feet up. When you drag your feet, you're holding yourself up. You're slowing yourself down. You got to pick them up and put them down. Pick them up and put them down. If you need to anchor up, then do that. If you need to anchor down, then do that. Whatever you need to wrap up, finish up, tidy up, whatever you need to pick up, please do that. Do that. Finish it. Just do it. Out of where you are and what you have been given. You've been given something. If you don't know what it is, get quiet and still and ask God. You've been given something. Tools. You've been given something. You just got to employ them. My God, you may have to deploy them. Ha ha. Oh God, you got to loose those arrows and let them flow. Pick your hand back up. I know it's been rough and all of that, but you owe you. I don't want you to let yourself down. I don't want you to let yourself down. I know that finish line seems like it's 1,000 miles away, but it's not. I know it seems like, my God, that you don't have breath, energy to take another doggone step, but you do. You do, because of the super on the natural. But see, in the word supernatural, super precedes natural. You got to put your part with God's part so y'all can do it together. Amen. That's all I have for you today. I do want to let you know that I've been listening to God for quite some months this year, and I'm going to be making some changes as far as the ministry goes and all of that. Want to let you know, I'm still fleshing it out, but I'm definitely going to be making some changes for 2022. And I'm excited about that because I want to be my best self, and I want to give my best self to the kingdom of God. And so I've got to listen to the Lord as he gives me leading and guidance on exactly how to do that. I made a post yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, that said, I almost made a post yesterday that said, you've got to listen to the instructions. And God is giving out end of year instructions, you guys. I want you to catch that. Somebody throw that up for somebody who's going to get this replay. God is giving out end of year instructions. Y'all were so hyped. I got testimony reports back. I got all kinds of affirmations and stuff about those bonus envelopes I told you God was pushing a couple of weeks ago. Oh my God, the excitement and all of that. Well, you know what? God is likewise giving out end of year instructions. He'll help you to finish it, whatever that looks like, so you can set yourself up with a launching pad to walk right in to 2022 with. It works together. One is not ending and 2022 beginning. 2021 is ushering in, is leading to 2022. Okay? Finish it. Don't say, I'll do it next year. What can you do today? The Bible said now you should finish what you started. But you can't finish it if you're not even working on it actively. All right. I love you so much. Thank you so much for diving with me today. I hope you got something good out of this. I'm asking you to please share the broadcast before you click off of here. Share the broadcast. If you would like to sow into the ministry, Jam Ministry, Jackie Avent Ministries, Dive In Ministries. If you would like to sow into the ministry, that information is there for you as well. The Lord will surely, surely bless your seed. Just share the video, sow a seed, go out of here in faith, grace, power, abilities, believe in God like never before. I want you to put a smile on your face today. I want you to know that God is still able. And even more than that, you know what I want you to know? I want you to know that there's a Nike anointing on you. I want you to know that not only is God still able, you are still able. You do have it in you. You can, you shall, you must, you will finish it. Refocus your focus and finish it. Pick your hands, put your hands back to the plow and move it forward. Even if you got to go slow, if you got to crawl with it, if you got to walk with it because you cannot run, okay, cool. God is not judging you on that. He just want to see some movement. You know why? Because movement inspires movement. You move and God will move. You move and heaven will move. You move and the angels will move. You move and the devil will move because he'll have to back up off of you because he see you like a steamroller coming through. Where the steamrollers at today? As we click off of here, if you see yourself as an eye of the tiger woman, an eye of the tiger man, if you see yourself as a finisher, no matter what it's been looking like, feeling like, sounding like all these 12 months of the year to this day, but you've got a fresh wave of something today, I want you to write steamroller. Where the steamrollers at? Where are the eagles that will fly right into the storm, right into the eye of the tiger? Where y'all at today? Where are the deep divers at? You don't get the treasure sitting on the shore. You can't get the treasure hanging around in the shallow waters, baby. That's why we've been diving for almost a solid year, because God wants you to get to the treasure. The treasure is way deep down there. You got to be courageous enough, willing enough. You got to get your oxygen levels up. You got to have a reserve tank, baby, in order to dive deep and go get that treasure. Where the divers at today? Where are the eye of the tiger people at today? Where the fighters at today? And fight, it don't necessarily mean that you got to be all fast and furious. Oh God, I thought I was through. It don't mean it like that. It just means that you're consistent. It means that you're committed, consistent, committed, creative. You care enough to do something with what you got, with where you are, and not worrying about the runner beside you or the runner behind you or even the runner before you. Y'all remember what happened with the tortoise and the hare? The hare was so cocky and so arrogant and so full of himself, and he just knew that he had it in the bag. And so guess what he did? He started dragging his feet. Ha ha! Hallelujah! He started dragging his feet. He got so up there with it, he said, yo. The tortoise is so far behind me. I think I can actually chill a bit and take a nap. And when he got up from dragging his feet, putting his anchor down too long. My God. He let his anchor down too long. And what happened? When he awoke from a restful sleep, the hare had consistently, methodically, strategically, my God, used his little short legs to do what he could do. And he had shot past the hare. And who ended up the winner? Don't let these little short legs fool you. Oh, Shabba. Don't you let these little short legs fool you. That's all I got. Truly, that's all I got. I bless God for you all today. I hope you have an amazing day. Do something. Do something. I don't know what you need to do to refocus your focus, but do something. Do something and finish it, Carol. Do something and finish it, Dr. Bobby. Y'all do something and finish it. Glory to God. And please go ahead and click tag and share for me. We need to get this word out, and we do it together like a chain link. Glory to God. If you want to sow, drop a seed. Just go ahead and do that. And no seed too small, nothing too big. Of course, whatever you want to do is led by the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Sometimes, you know, you got to put a seed on it. Sometimes, you know, you got to put a faith stamp on what you say and what you believe. Thank you. Somebody caught that. Committed, consistent, and creative. You got to do it. You got to do it. You got to do it at your level, at your ability, at your means, and God will bless. You shall, you can, you will, you must refocus your focus and finish it. God bless. Have an amazing day. God willing, I'll see you back here for the last, my God, hallelujah, the last Thursday in the year of 2021. Have an amazing day. I love y'all guys so much. I'll be lifting up a prayer for you during the day, calling your name out as always. And if you need me, you know how to reach me. God bless you. Bye.